Be Wealthy and Smart, episode 854.
Into a world of wealth and financial freedom without budgets, boredom, or bosses on Be Wealthy and Smart. And now, here's your host, Linda P. Jones.
Welcome to Be Wealthy and Smart. I'm Linda P. Jones, America's Wealth Mentor, empowering women and men worldwide to financial freedom. On today's show, we're going to talk about where should you invest your stimulus check? Because there's actually a poll that's been done on where most people are going to invest their stimulus check. And I thought it was kind of interesting. And we would go through each option and talk about the possibilities. Because you might be thinking about that yourself. What should you do with your stimulus check? Now, obviously, if you're behind on your rent or your groceries, you know the answer. You need to pay the emergency situation if that's what the situation is that you're in. Take care of the basics, take care of your emergency situation. But then there is a group of people who aren't in that situation and who have been working through this pandemic and have ample income, their bills are paid, and they're wondering, what should I do with my stimulus money? So let's see how most people answered this Bloomberg survey. And this article comes to us from ZeroHedge.com. It says, here's how Americans said they will spend their latest $1,400 stimulus check. And somewhere down the article, it says, respondents to a new survey said overwhelmingly that the money would first go to things like savings, food, and housing. Following that was paying down credit card debt, home improvements, and health care. Well, let's break this all down. The top response, 34%, said they would spend their stimulus check on savings. As well you should. If you don't have savings, you need to have savings. But if you have a lot of savings, getting a very low interest rate at the bank is not going to change your financial situation. It's insane, the low interest rates. And thinking that that is going to get you anywhere or change your financial situation, it just isn't. Now, we all need savings. I'm not saying that. You do need to have an emergency savings account, of course. But some people save so much money and they don't do anything with their money, so their money isn't working for them. And that is what I want to talk about, is not putting all your money into savings and letting it sit there at this terribly low, below 1% interest rate situation. All right, the next response was 30% said they would spend their money on food. That's very good. You need to get food. You need to put food on the table. That's an ongoing expense. You can use your stimulus for that. Some people are getting their stimulus on debit cards, and it's very easy to take the debit card to the store, buy gas or groceries. Great idea. The third response was housing. 22% said they are going to spend it on housing. Now, assuming that they have rent payments or mortgage payments that are due or past due, that, of course, can be a very good use of their stimulus money. 18% said they would spend it on credit card debt. So paying off debt, that high interest rate, 17%, 20 plus percent. Credit card debt, when you pay that down, it's like earning that interest rate. So paying off a 17% rate card is like earning 17% because you're not having to pay that in interest. So that is one of the actual ways where you're actually getting ahead financially from this option of paying down credit card debt. 11% said they would pay for home improvement. A lot of people want to create an office at home or need to change around some things at home. With the pandemic, it changed their work situation, so now their home situation has changed. I get it. So if you are in the middle of a remodel project, you probably want to put your money towards that. The next highest answer was healthcare. 9% said they will spend it on healthcare. Again, health is super important. It's right up there at the top in terms of what is important, and we need to take care of health, family, housing, food. All of those things, of course, are very, very important. The next highest answer was clothes. 8% said they would spend their stimulus check on clothes. Well, depending on your age, that might be more important to you than others, but I would say maybe you could put off buying some more clothes and put your money to better use. So we'll put this one aside for a minute. 6% said they would make an investment in the stock market. Well, with all the crazy speculation going on and Wall Street bets doing different things and people investing in different stocks and the stock market feeling more like a casino than ever, I can understand that people think they're going to be getting ahead by putting some money in the stock market. But again, you have to look at all your investment opportunities. So we're going to put this one aside for a minute as well. The next response was childcare, 5%. I'm not going to argue. I don't think that merits any further discussion. Of course, 5% said they would go on a vacation or trip, which sounds fabulous, but there's also opportunity costs with planning a vacation or trip, because what else could you have done with that money? Could it have made money for you? That's something we also want to set aside and talk about later. 4% said they would spend their money on education. Education is always a wise thing in terms of trying to better your situation, to get the next rung up on the ladder of a job or a higher paying income that can impact your entire life. So if your education can help you earn more money, that's usually a good investment. The next highest response was 4% said they would spend it on electronics. I'm assuming that's either gaming or a phone or something along those lines. Let's set that one aside too and talk about that in another category. 3% said they would invest in cryptocurrencies, which we're going to talk about in a minute, and 2% said they would spend it on student loans. Student loans, of course, are still being talked about in terms of debt forgiveness, so just think about that. There may be a possibility of up to $50,000 of debt forgiveness for student loans coming. That's still on the table. All right, so let's talk about some of these optional areas that are not necessary for you to live or to keep a roof over your head, but they may be something where you can choose what to do with your money. And maybe you want to choose something that might actually make some money for you. Here's what I mean. If last fall you got $600 in your stimulus money and you happen to invest that in one of my favorite cryptocurrencies, that $600 today would have grown 528% to $3,168. And for a couple that had $1,200 to invest, had you invested in that, that would have grown to $6,336. Now, I can't guarantee that that's going to happen again. I can't guarantee that going forward, that's what you could get in cryptocurrencies. But I can say that the growth rates for cryptocurrencies are out of this world. And it's not something that I see as a short-term trend. I don't see this as a speculation. What I see this as is early adoption of the next major technology. And I've talked about it in this way, that back in the late 90s, we had the internet come into being and internet stocks went crazy for a few years. And people didn't understand what was happening. They didn't understand what the internet was. They didn't understand how the internet was going to change our lives. And that a few companies that came into existence at that time would grow into $1 trillion valuations each. So there is massive opportunity where there's new technology. But here's the thing. I don't believe that every single cryptocurrency, and there's over 7,500 of them now, I don't believe that every one of those has a use or will survive. I think you have to do significant research, do a lot of digging, and find out which ones are likely to be the big winners. The way you can tell who the big winners are in the future is who has the big lead now. If a company has massive adoption by certain financial institutions or certain companies as a payment system, that might be a big winner. But they also need to have superior technology. Are they the technology that is green energy? Are they the technology that's fast and low cost? Are they the cryptocurrency that checks all the boxes? Because you know I haven't been a fan of Bitcoin, which is rather limited. It is a store of value. It has gone up a lot in value. I don't argue that, but it's still not my favorite investment because it takes more energy than the country of Argentina in a year. It's very slow to process and it's very expensive in terms of its fees per transaction. That's not something that can be mass adopted. Rather, my favorite cryptocurrency is something that can handle trillions of dollars on its system. It's less than a penny in order to transact millions of dollars. And it's green energy, meaning it takes very little energy to transact, and it happens in less than 3 seconds, typically. So what's my point? My point is you need to do heavy research before you invest in a cryptocurrency. You need to understand what you're investing in and why, but you also need to understand this is a completely separate asset class. This is not like stocks. These are early technologies that are just above the venture capital stage, which means that they have a lot of compounding ahead of them because their companies are going to grow massively in the future. They're building their technology on the blockchain, which is a computerized system that identifies every single transaction and is hack-proof, so that in the future, we'll be able to settle real estate contracts using computers, and we won't need to have lots of different people handling the transactions, such as the loan officer, the appraiser, the title officer, the lawyer, the escrow. All of that can be transacted instantaneously using computer code because the same steps happen for every single closing. Once that goes on a smart contract and gets recorded on the blockchain, that is an unhackable transaction, and it's something that everyone can verify and see that is accurate. This is the next level of technology to where we're going. It's built above and beyond the internet. It's the next level above the internet, and it's going to impact everything that we do. And that's why the very wealthiest of clients are getting into it at Goldman Sachs and at Morgan Stanley. They just announced they are letting their wealthiest, their private wealth clients, get into cryptocurrencies. Do you think if it was a fad that Goldman Sachs and Morgan Stanley would allow or recommend their wealthiest clients invest in cryptocurrency? I don't think so. Why would they take that risk? So they are validating it is not a fad. It is not a scam. It is not something that is going to go away. It is here to stay. It is a new asset class, and it's something that is growing at a faster rate than just about anything on the stock market. So when we look at opportunities for you to compound money, which is what I love to do as the queen of compounding, I love to see where can you compound your money best. I'm not saying to put all your money into cryptocurrency, but I am recommending 5% for my clients in the Be Wealthy and Smart VIP experience. We moved that up from 3% to 5% as we got more comfortable with cryptocurrencies. And as I saw my clients adapt to it and take to it like a fish to water, they love the cryptocurrencies. They found it a bit of a steep learning curve at first, but once they really got into it and really went through the whole tutorial that I had set up for them, then they got it. They saw the potential. And they've been able to reap the benefits to the tune of over 500% since last October when we first got invested. Now, along with Goldman Sachs and Morgan Stanley talking about their wealthiest clients coming into cryptocurrencies, we also see governments are talking about central bank digital currencies. And central bank digital currencies mean that they are going to create their version of their paper currency onto the computer. Why? So that when you go to the grocery store, you can simply pay with your phone. So that when you go to Home Depot, you can check out with your phone. So that when you go buy a cup of coffee, you can pay with your phone. Pretty much everybody in China is paying with their phone, from what I hear, and very few people are using paper money. It's pretty much all digital currency. And that's why companies like the Dallas Mavericks, Mark Cuban's company, is now accepting a cryptocurrency for payment. You see, it's starting here too. It's been happening in places where technology is a little bit more advanced or perhaps maybe a little bit more comfortable using it. But we are going to have those digital versions of the US dollar, digital versions of every world currency available on our phone. And it's going to be easier than ever to exchange from one currency to another, and also less expensive with lower fees. So this is where technology is going. We're recognizing that now. We're early investors in this. I'm so excited to be in ahead of some of the wealthiest people just starting to invest in this, because behind them is going to be the big retail market. That's the big wall of money that's going to be coming in. Because once the wealthiest and Morgan Stanley have invested in cryptocurrency, I'll bet you the same thing will happen. They'll go from 3% asset allocation to 5% asset allocation, and then they'll want to get their retail investors involved as well, because they'll see that their wealthiest love cryptocurrency. They enjoy it. They're loving the returns on it as well. And they'll want their retail investors to have that opportunity to have growth and exposure. And I think the retail investor is going to demand it. Once the returns are known, and once they see how the high net worth and the ultra high net worth and private wealth are doing, they're going to want the same investments for themselves at the retail level. People that don't have $10 million plus, they're going to want to have the same access to these same investments. So what can you do with your stimulus check? Well, yes, savings, food, housing, of course, healthcare, childcare, of course. Basics, things that you cannot do without, you must spend money on those things. But things that are a little bit more optional, maybe clothing, maybe going on vacation right now, or electronics, maybe you want to postpone that a little bit and see if you can't put your money to good use and get your money working harder for you so you don't have to work so hard. I just wanted to have that conversation with you from a compounding perspective for where I see the greatest opportunities for compounding and wealth building in the markets today. I still feel it's cryptocurrencies, heads and tails above anything else out there. Not that other things can't do well. I still think silver will do well. I still think other investments that we're in are going to do extremely well. But cryptocurrencies are in an asset class by themselves. They're completely different from everything else. They move differently, they compound differently, and they're earlier than anything else out there. So if you want to learn more about cryptocurrencies, check out some of my past podcasts on cryptocurrencies. You can go to my website at lyndapjones.com/podcasts. There's a search box on my podcast page, and you can put in crypto or cryptocurrencies in there and search for all of my crypto podcasts. There's about 6 of them that you can listen to really quickly, probably in less than an hour, and be really up to date with what's going on with cryptocurrencies and get a little bit more background on them. If you haven't yet subscribed to Be Wealthy and Smart, hit the subscribe button and you'll be notified as soon as new podcasts are available so you never miss one of them. That's all for today. Until next time, live the good life and be wealthy and smart.
Thank you for listening to Be Wealthy and Smart with Linda P. Jones. Share the wealth and tell your family and friends about the show. Check out our website, blog, and social media for more riches at www.bewealthyandsmart.com.